So when you went, to the infamous interviewing Tupac in L.A. while the Biggie beef, all that's going on, Puffy and them mad at you? Was Bad Boy mad at you for interviewing Tupac?
This is where we're going, Joey.
No.
Okay. No, you know why I get nervous? Is because...
Oh, no, I'm not jamming you up, never.
No, listen, you're not jamming me up. Trust me, it's fine. I can talk about anything, but...
I don't jam nobody up on a Fat Joe show.
Nah, it's fine. You say shit you want to say. No, the problem is, I have this Tupac...
I'm saying, well, they upset with you. You're from New York, the voice of New York. You going
they
out
didn't
there
love
to
it.
Interview Tupac. Huh?
No, they didn't love it. They didn't love it.
Also, they was a little upset about that. I never knew that.
Yeah, they didn't love it. It took me and Big a minute. I'm so happy that we got to a better place after, because Big didn't love it. He never told me, but somebody else told me. But we had spoke about, we didn't speak about it, but we just kind of smoothed it out. And then he wound up coming, it was my birthday, and he came up to my show and he wanted to freestyle, and it was all good. It was fine. But, you know, I did my best to protect everybody in that space. Like, everybody knows the story that I didn't air the whole thing because I was really worried about making it worse. And I just tried to do the best I could in that situation. And I think ultimately that's all you could ever do, right? And if you know in your heart you try to do the right thing all the time and you hope that people respect it.
Because you guys would look upon as, I'm telling you from an artist perspective, I love you as a sister and brother. I'm not saying you, but... Hot 97 was looked upon as the evil empire at one point because it was the only game in town. It was no other station. And it was like, you better do what the fuck they say or you're fucked.